Hello everyone! Again, you can watch me make some resin geodecosis again. And this time I chose a nice bright green color. And to create the beautiful effects that I got in my other videos, I'm using the puddle technique again. And I hope I inspire you all to also try this technique, because it's so much fun. So for the new people to my channel that like tutorials of resin, like this one, or other tutorials about acrylic, alcohol ink, mixed media, consider to subscribe, click the notification bell and select all, because that way you don't miss any future videos that I will be uploading to my channel. So I'm going to make 4 geodecosis again, and what I already mentioned, I'm going to make them in a nice bright green color. And this color is one of my own natural mica pigments. It's a color that is called key lime. So on the edge I want a nice bright green color. And again, I'm using the Art Pro resin from the Resin Pro company. And it's an amazing resin, and it has a really nice finish, and I also like the consistency. It's not too thick but also not too thin. And if you're interested in this resin, I have a promo code, and if you use my code Petra, then you get 10% discount on your total value order. So all the information to that is in the description box. And I also got some questions about people that asked if I waited to pour the resin until it's a little bit thicker. I'm not doing that. I mix it. I mix my colors in it and then I pour it right away. So the next color is a mixture of 2 colors alcohol ink by Pinata. I'm using the Sun Bright Yellow and 1 drop of Calabasa Orange, and then you get this color. It's very transparent, so I will be filling the whole layer with this color. So hopefully I will get some nice coasters, and also the backside. I hope also the backside is nice, then they can be used on both sides. So for the people that are interested in my own natural mica pigments from my pigment line Just Paint, I have listed them in my Etsy shop, but they are also available in the USA and Canada by my associate Evelyn Schaefer. She has them also listed in her Etsy shop, and she has some great discounts and free shipping above $30. US dollars, so that's great. All the information to my natural mica pigments is in the description box below this video. And also again, I'm using the mold, the silicone mold of Molds and Shapes. If you're interested in this silicone mold, the link to their Facebook page is in the description box. And yeah, they don't have a website, they only have a Facebook page. So if you're interested, the only thing you need to do is send them a message that you are interested in a mold to buy it, and then it will all be okay. So the heat gun to remove some air bubbles. And on top, I'm using the Lures Cool Mint. Very nice opaque color. It's a paste. And I think it will give me a nice contrast with the other colors. So a small puddle in the middle. And on top, I'm using the Resin Pro White Paste. Also pour it in the middle of the cool mint. For the white you can also use the casting craft. That will give you the same effects. And on top of the white, I'm using again the Sun Bright Yellow from Pinata, the alcohol ink, and I pour it in the middle, and that way I push the colors to the outside, but also to the bottom. And the cool mint and the white already react to the alcohol ink, the Sun Bright Yellow. So all the supplies I'm using in this video you can find in the description box of the video with the links to the websites, as I always do. So if you're curious, please check out the description box. I'm using my embossing tool to remove some air bubbles. And then again I'm pour a small puddle of the cool mint from Lares in the middle. And again on top the white paste from Resin Pro. And again in the middle, but this time I'm using clear resin. I'm pushing those two colors to the outside, but also to the bottom. And I'm not going to fill this mold all the way to the top, because I think the coasters will be too thick then. They are, if you fill them all the way to the top, the coasters will be 1.5 centimeters thick, and I'm only want them 1 centimeter thick, so that's why I'm not pouring it all the way to the top. Now I'm adding again a little bit of glitter, and I mixed the Cosmic Shimmer Hunter Green together with the Cosmic Shimmer Holographic Rainbow Black Glitter, and I also added some green iridescent flitter flakes. So I'm only going to add a little bit of this glitter mixture in the middle. Yeah, and I also want to take the time to thank Barbara for her donation to my channel. I appreciate it a lot, Barbara, and it helps me to buy the materials for making these coasters and also other art. So thank you so much for doing that. I appreciate it a lot. Now I'm adding a little bit of the clear resin on top of the glitter mix. So in this video you will see the total process. I will show you also a close-up right after I poured it. And the unmolding, so taking them out of the mold, but also an end result close-up from the front, but also the backside. But that's at the end of the video. So again, I'm using my embossing tool to remove the air bubbles. And then I'm done with my coasters. And then I will show you all a close-up after 1 hour of drying. So this is the close-up after 1 hour of drying. They changed a bit, and I think those colors blended so nice together. Hopefully the backside is also nice, but I'm already very pleased with this side, the front side. And I like those colors very much together. It sparkles a lot, and that's because of my own mica pigment, the key lime. I also like the cool mint center with a little bit of the glitter mix. Yeah, I'm very pleased how this looks, and hopefully it will stay this way during drying. But yeah, you will never know. A little bit closer now. There you can see the glitter mix. Yeah, I'm very happy how they look. So we are almost 24 hours later, and I'm going to take them out of the mold. I need to be very careful because they are very bendy, and but I'm always very careful if I take them out of the mold. But the first one is out of the mold. That went okay. And the front side, this side stayed the way it is. So that's good because I like this side very much. I like the cool mint center, but also the sparkle of the key lime. There you can see that I take them out very carefully because I don't want to damage them or the mold. That's the third one. And the last one. And now we can take a closer look. I think this side looks great. So how will the backside look? I'm very curious. And that is the backside. So the cool mint is very nice on the backside. I will show you a close-up, then you can see the effects much better. But I'm also liking this side. Very nice. So a closer look of the front, very sparkly, and then the back. Yeah, you can see a spot that is not shiny, so I will be adding a layer to it because I don't like it. So this is a close-up of the front side, outside, in the sun, and hopefully you can see the effects much better. But I'm liking this side very much. It has some nice effects. I also like the glitter mix in the middle. And it also it has some transparency. And I love those colors together. Very nice. Now a closer look. Yeah, I'm very pleased. And this is a close-up of the backside. What I already mentioned, I've added an extra layer on the backside because I didn't like the spot that was not shiny enough for me. So I added an extra layer, so they are great now. And I like the effects very much. So let me know what you think of these coasters, which side you like the best. I'm liking both. I can't choose. There a closer look of the Cool Mint with the nice effects with the key line, my own natural mica pigments. So the information to that is in the description box. Also the link to my Facebook, Instagram, influencers, Amazon store. Also for the Dutch people, I also have links to the Dutch Amazon page, so a website. So if you're curious, please check out the description box. There's a lot of information in the description box, so I want to thank you all for watching again, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!